Peggy 18.
I'm just gonna say it. This is exactly what goes down in horror movies.
I gotta ask, is it interesting for you to see kind of how the scenes play out from the other characters' perspectives? Because you're shooting a certain scene and a certain ending or a certain piece in your story, but then at the same time, the other characters shooting theirs. So it must be really interesting to kind of see how other people take that.
Yeah, for sure. It has been. It has been. And I think it's one of those things I like.
Oh, she made her death sound so much better than my death.
Oh, 100%. Oh, that's constant for me. I don't want to go off to Ellen. I was like, let's start. Yeah, we all joke about that. She's got the most incredible scream ever. And so anytime there's some screaming and Ellen's up first, it feels like following Pavarotti on stage afterwards. It's like, do we have to really? And no matter how many times I do it, I won't reach those heights.
What are you excited for players to experience with this game? Any advice maybe you have for players of how they should, you know, navigate these waters?
I think have fun with all the different alternative paths and die again, try again. That's one of the really fun things about this game in particular, is that there are so many different pathways that you can explore. And there's a real sense of mystery, and I think it does require genuine effort and endeavor to discover the clues and decode the broader conundrum that the game offers up.
Come and check this out.
What on earth is that?
Not a clue.
Who do you think is going to be the favorite character in this game?
I think Ellen's character, Angela.
Really?
Yeah, she's just awesome, and she puts everyone right in their place.
Hey, Daniel, you guys!
I am not a guy?
How are you two doing down there?
This little detour is ruining my clothes!
That's the headline here? Really?
John, played by Alex, the professor, I think likes to think of himself as the leader, and Angela as a character is just brilliant at putting him in his place and keeping the young'uns all in check, and she's super funny, and I've loved watching that character come to life.
Yeah. Well, I thought we'd end with some rapid-fire questions to cover some things that we have not covered yet. So, all right, first up, are you easily scared?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah, I wanted to lie, but yes.
What scares you?
I'm still one of those people that, like, if it's dark and it's silent in a house and I'm the only one around, I just like to turn a few lights on. I'm that kind of person.
You don't know what's there.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Have you ever seen a ghost or experienced anything supernatural?
I haven't. My last name's Poulter, Poltergeist. I grew up with a lot of ghost gags, but that's really as close as I've come. Never actually experienced anything supernatural. I've lived it. I've lived as a ghost.
A witch or a demon?
I'm gonna go with witch, I think. Demons are just legitimately evil. And as we discuss in the game, all witches were innocent. So I'm gonna go with witches.
All right. 1900s or 1600s?
Ooh, 1900s.
I feel like there were more amenities in the 1900s.
A few more home comforts.
You know, yeah.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Would you rather be chased by a demon or accused by a witch hunter? I mean, I feel like there's really no winning that.
Yeah, well, if you're chased by a witch hunter, there really is no winning that. There was actually no way out of that. And a lot of the trials they used to put women accused of being witches through ended up in death or death. So really, there's no way out of it. So at least there's an opportunity to escape a demon. So I'd rather be pursued by a demon, which sounds like a strange thing to say.
Well, I feel like now you've got some skills too, being in this game. Maybe you know a thing or two of how to survive a possible demon attack.
Yeah, if I got the gang together again, maybe, with their help.
All right, Will.
Tanner, thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate that. Thank you.
Cheers.